welcome to Q-Shala. Here, you will get to learn new things while answering fun questions. Let me tell you a story. Dali, a Dublin Playhouse manager, once put in a bet to make a word popular overnight that doesn't exactly have a meaning. The next day, when people woke up to a bright morning, they saw the letters Q, U, I, Z scribbled all over the walls of the city. Now, this is said to be one of the stories behind how quiz as a word came into existence. In literature, Charlotte Bronte and Jane Austen have used quiz to mean eccentric in their works. Now let us understand, what is quizzing? Quizzes are competitions that combine general knowledge, logical reasoning, and analysis. The days of dry facts being doled out like an imposition are long gone. Today, quizzes are competitions that require you to make clever, Holmesian deductions from subtle clues in the questions. Using audio-visual clues to work out the questions is important. The foundation of quizzes is a question. A good question should be many things, like educational, thought-provoking, can be worked out with a few clues, is appropriate for the audience's age, is factual, is to the point, and most importantly, interesting. Let us actually understand this with an example. In 2011, at the Disney 23 exhibition, producer Jonas Rivera announced a new film that was set for release in 2015. The movie saw it premiered on June 8, 2015 at the El Capitan Theatre in Hollywood and received a wide theatrical release starting on June 19, 2015 in Disney Digital 3D, Real-D 3D and select IMAX 3D theatres. The film also hired a psychologist named Dasha Keltner, who is an expert on emotions. Which movie starring Amy Poehler in a voice role is being talked about? Did you get the answer? Let's try another way. Which 2015 Disney film starring Amy Poehler in a voice role hired an emotions expert named Dasha Keltner to give an accurate depiction of the human mind? Did you get the answer now? If you thought about the movie Inside Out, you are absolutely right. Good job. Now, it's time to understand the difference between these two kinds of questions in detail. The first kind has too much text. Some bits of information are not that necessary to arrive at the answer. By the time you finish reading the question, you might just get bored. Another difference is that the important clue is not highlighted. Here's the second type of question. This is short and has the important clues highlighted. Adding to this, the image is a better hint to arrive at the answer. Now is your chance to make good questions. Make any question based on a topic of your choice and send it to us in the comments. Answering questions is not easy. And answering them in a high-pressure situation, like a quiz competition, is not a piece of cake. Here's Q-Shala's co-founder, Mr. Raghav Chakravarti, telling us his quizzing journey.
My quizzing journey started off with my parents bought, this set of World Book Encyclopedia to home. My brother was very curious and used to read a lot. Used to ask a lot of questions during dinner to my dad, and that conversations, I think, was like this initial spark for me to also read and learn more, etc. So World Book Encyclopedia kind of really played a catalyst. My first kind of quiz that I got to participate was this Maggie quiz, which is an inter-school quiz that was organized in my school, and winning the quiz in front of my classmates. And you know, it was very dramatic because it went to the wire with a question, with a tiebreaker. And I still remember the question, which is, where is Hollywood situated? And I remember buzzing and going and saying, Hollywood in California. And that was the first victory that kind of, you know, set the tone for, participating in more quizzes, or the joy of winning through quizzes. That validation was very strong. Those are probably the two sparking points for me to start the quizzing journey. Some of the challenges we faced while in school, while participating in quizzes, one was discovering quizzes that were happening across the city. That was a challenge. Thankfully, later on, we got to discover this association of passionate quizzes called the Karnataka Quiz Association, which used to organize quizzes almost on a fortnightly basis in Delhi Memorial Hall in Bangalore. And we used to take the bus, go on weekends, participate in these quizzes. That was one kind of thing that helped us solve that. And secondly, in school, the teacher coordinators were very gracious to introduce us to many inter-school quiz competitions, and that became one of the ways. But there wasn't one place in which we could discover many quizzes that were happening across the city. So that was one. The second one was, train for a quiz, right? Because questions can be asked from anywhere, right? And current affairs, world is an oyster. So how to prepare for a quiz was also one of the things that was a little difficult. Because and probably the fact that we started attending more and more quizzes, watching Bonvita Quiz Contest, Mastermind on TV, and that kind of allowed us to figure out what are the different resources that would help us do well in, or to be abreast in, and things like that, and build your own way of preparing for these quizzes, note taking and things like that. And the third one I would say was, many of us kind of find that difficult to find the right quiz partner. But thankfully, we were a motley group of friends in school who were very interested in knowing a lot, or generally curious bunch of kids. So I did find, very good quiz partners while in school. And that really played with complementary skills, right? So I had Santosh M. Harish, where we participated in Bonvita Quiz Contest. We had Pranav Ravi Kumar, who was my quiz partner all over school and my pre-university education, and then Sachin, who's my present co-founder in Qshala, who was my quiz partner in college. And we traveled quite a bit, and we were quite fortunate to win some prestigious quizzes across the country as a result as well. I would like to talk about two instances. One of my childhood quiz partners is Pranav from school. He went on, we went for this inter-school quiz competition conducted by Bishop Cotton's called Exquisite. And it had over 500 participants from across the country who had come. And we got lucky, and we got selected with a preliminary round to the finals. And we were leading the first two rounds. And then, Pranav took a couple of negatives, three negatives in a row, and then we were bottom of the tally at the end of the third round. And we had only two more rounds to be able to, and they had this thing where on the fourth round, there was also an elimination. So we had to do well. And I remember at that stage, we backed ourselves and we were able to somehow scrape through the elimination, the fourth round. And in the fifth round, we went on to win the quiz. And I remember the quizmaster, Mr. Giriga Balasubramaniam, asking us this question, were you not angry with your quiz partner for taking those three negatives, which would have like meant, almost losing the quiz at such a competitive quiz, right? And it was his birthday, and I told him that I could not be angry with him. And I got all the audience members to wish him a happy birthday. And I think that was a very happy memory for me from the quiz, where as a team, we we allowed for my team member to make that mistake, but we backed ourselves and got back into the quiz in the right spirit of quizzing. And my second memory would be while I was as a college law student, when I was interning as a legal assistant under Justice Muralidhar in Muralidhar sir in Delhi High Court. Muralidhar sir talked about how he was interested in, had his dream of conducting a quiz for law students. And I remember he said, why don't you put together a question set and we can see how we can make it come alive. So I went back to college, I created a set, I sent him one set, and I said, it's a work in progress, sir, and I'll get back to you. After college, I took out my job, and after 2 years of corporate, as a corporate lawyer, and I quit, we started Kyushala, I wrote back to sir with another question bank of questions. And I remember sir saying, now we need to bring this to life. And thankfully, there's Dr. Sudhir Krishnaswamy, who has a similar vision of bringing such a quiz property. And, we were in talks and we built, and he was like, we came up with this quiz called Conquest, which is on constitutional history and politics. And the first edition of the quiz, when we were conducting the Delhi round, it was almost coming full circle when we had Justice Murali sir and Dr. Ravindra Bhatt sir, who was the present judge of the Supreme Court, who were guest quiz masters of the quiz. And that was a very, very happy memory, almost looking at a full circle coming together. So that those two are memories which are something I truly cherish. I would like to say, one is to be curious, read, learn more, ask questions. That should be your primary concern. Don't bother about if you give a wrong answer, what people think. You will realize that the journey of asking questions, regardless of whether they're right or wrong, is the best way of becoming a sharp quizzer. Two, have conversations with your friends. Share interesting fundas with your friends and family. Conduct quizzes for your friends and family. And I think that's a great way to also learn. Three, for me, one of it was actually note-taking. While attending quizzes or where I, every day when I used to read something and I used to make notes of it. And that really played an important role where I started creating my own database of questions. And that really played an important role as well. So if you start thinking like a quiz master, it really help you when you are quizzing. So those would be some of the tips that I would say. But most of all, enjoy the process of learning, participating, and really exploring new things. And that is at the heart of quizzing. So cheers.
That was chapter one of How to Be a Pro Quizzer. If you like this chapter, like and share the video. Subscribe to Kyushala for more such engaging content. Next week, we will be discussing about different kinds of questions and how to approach them. See you soon.